right and not a divine right to ask me to diminish my power and my authority over you. And so he declares, in this case, Russell Crowe is playing the leading character, who made the initial request that the king agreed to. He declares he's an outlaw. He's going to accept no challenge to his authority at all. It's called a divine right of kings. Now, what does that mean to live in that time? It means that whoever is in charge, king, queen, Caesar, Pharaoh, emperor, they get to make all the rules. And they claim that the authority to do that is from God. Therefore, their rules cannot be challenged. Nietzsche says what happens then throughout the course of history is you get a ruling class, become the masters. And they make up all the rules. What that does then is if you buy into the system and you have no choice, you notice when the people who were the kind of the hierarchy tried to challenge him immediately, I mean, they just willing to kill him. If they would have challenged him, they'd have killed every one of them. He didn't care. There's always people to replace them. His authority is unquestionable, or whether it be the queen or anybody else. The authority is unquestionable. You don't challenge that kind of authority because it's ingrained in you that if you challenge that authority, you're really challenging a divine presence where that authority originates from. So they get to make up all the rules. Their values then are equated with the good. So you have a superior class of people, very small class of people that make up all the rules. Everybody else is literally their slaves. They don't like to say it that way, but they're their slaves. Their values are inferior, and therefore they're considered bad. So we have good and bad. This is the origin of moral balance. Everybody with me on that? Nietzsche says what happens in this kind of a system is eventually the slaves, and I'll bring this up for you in the notes so you see it, resent the fact that the rulers are imposing on them whatever the rulers think they should. They can overtax them, they can take their lives, they can do whatever they want to them, they have no choice. And therefore, they revolt. The slaves reinterpret the value system. This is called a revaluation. And they say, our values are good, and these values are no longer bad, they're evil. What they do then is they seek to replace the master system with themselves. They become the new masters, and they invent a new class of slaves. Nietzsche then looks at history, and he says, what's been going on is this repetitive mistake that somehow someone thinks they have the divine right to set all the values for everybody else. They're the good, and everything else is bad. But eventually resentment, and you see this historically, occurs, and those that are under the authority of the masters revolt, usually through resentment. Because these people, in order to endure this kind of rulership, adopt principles like, altruistic principles like, turn the other cheek and endure the pain. God will reward, and I'm not being critical of religion when I say this, God will reward you with heaven and reward them with hell. So you put up with this because you really don't have a choice unless you revolt. And when you revolt, there's no other system other than to replace those in this system with yourself. So the slaves become the new masters, they invent the new slave class. And Nietzsche says this has been going on for 8,000 years. And the problem with that is there's an assumption that morality is at the heart of this issue. So Nietzsche writes a book called Beyond Good and Evil. Not good and bad, but good and evil. He says the problem is for 8,000 years we bought into a moral system that he says doesn't exist. It's a creation. It's a creation to justify the power and authority of the masters over the slaves. When the slaves finally break free and they revolt, they stay within the same system that Nietzsche says has not a right to exist because it's a false narrative. Nietzsche says there's no morality. How can you say that, Nietzsche? How can you say there's no morality? Well, Nietzsche's 100 years ahead of his time. Nietzsche was more about string theory and energy than those who live in his time. Don't forget Aristotle, 2,700 years before, for the Western world, invents teleology. Morality is based on consequences. If actions produce desired consequences, where those are good, those are good. Kant comes along and says if the action's the right action, regardless of consequences, that's a good action. And Nietzsche says that's a false narrative. We're trying to justify behavior.